Next speaker is Masahito Hayashi, and the title of their talk is Secure List Decoding and its Application to Bit String Commitment. So, yeah, the floor is yours, Masahito Hayashi.
Can you hear me? Hello?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay, thanks. So today I want to talk about secure list decoding and its application to bitstring commitment. So this is talk for only classical. There is no quantum issue, sorry, but I belong to some quantum institute. So this is the motivation for the secure list decoding. So first, I explain the motivation for secure list decoding. And later, I discuss its application to the bitstring commitment. So this is the motivation. As you know, list decoding, there is not so many applications for list decoding. Then I want to find a good application for list decoding. List decoding is a decoding method to list several candidates of message in the decoding process. The following trivial method achieves the optimum rate in this formulation. One code word is used for the different L message, where L is the number of lists. So we would like to rule out such a trivial code. Equivalence rate is employed as another parameter. So this is the motivation. So this one is some explanation. So this is a trivial code, example of trivial code. For example, we have one to two L message. However, initial L message coded to the only code word zero, and other message is coded to the one. And in the decoder, list up to the one to L, or decoder received one, so decoder list L plus one to two L. That kind of trivial extension is not so interesting. However, that kind of trivial one achieves the capacity in the sense of list decoding, even in quantum setting, right? So that kind of trivial method is not so interesting. So I want to rule out such a trivial one.
Professor Hayashi?
Yes?
Your slides are not moving. I cannot see the slides. They are not moving. You are still on the first slide.
First slide?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Window が共有しています。Can you see this one?
Yes, but you must move it. Yeah.
This one is okay, but if I use that one, so not so good. Okay, now I understand. So in that case, maybe I need to change share screen method. Firstly, I stop sharing, and we should share full screen. So then we can see if yes. So okay. Then we can see correct one. Sorry, mistake. So this is content and this is motivation. So sorry, I want to rule out that trivial list decoding. So there is an L list and our message, first L message coded to zero and list to one to L in the decoder size. And another one is this one. So this kind of code is not so interesting. This is trivial, but that trivial method can attain the capacity, even in the general setting. So this is not so interesting. So then I want to rule out that situation. So as you know, there is another topic Bitstring commitment via Noisy Channel. Firstly, this topic was discussed by Andreas Winter. Of course, in the crypto person, somehow they discussed that problem, but Andreas Winter drive the, and Edward, they drive the capacity, so Bitstring capacity. So what is the following? But this problem has a following problem. So they did not discuss the transmission rate when the transmission rate is larger than commitment capacity. Of course, they mentioned that if the transmission rate is larger than commitment capacity, so they cannot recover. So, but if we relax the security condition, maybe we have some advantage. So we want to consider that situation. And the second topic is their method is limiting the discrete scales. So their output system limited the final set. So existing result of the conditional set, output set is very limited. So we want to extend our result to the continuous case. So this is the formulation for the bit string commitment based on the list decoding via noisy channel. Essentially, Andreas' paper and other existing paper for bit string commitment is essentially based on the list decoding. So in that case, in the commitment phase, Alice sends her message to M, and Bob via noisy channel, and Bob output L message as a list. This list is required to contain the message M. So this is a requirement for the commitment phase. And in the reveal phase, Alice sends her message to M, to Bob, via noiseless channel, and if M is contained in the Bob's decoded list, Bob accepts it. Otherwise, Bob rejects it. This is a standard construction for the bitstring commitment. So in the bitmap commitment, there is a two requirement. First requirement is concealing condition. So for some security parameter delta, when Alice is honest, we have this inequality. So M is the message. So for different message, and D1 is the information for Bob during Bob's information during the commitment phase. So during commitment phase, Bob obtain only D1. In that case, there is almost no difference for the even input message. So this is a requirement. And this is a concealing condition, and the binding condition is the following. So please remember that G2 is the information Bob obtained during the reveal phase. So for delta B, so the message M is subject to the uniform distribution on M. So this is the assumption. Then when Alice and Bob are honest, in this case, this is Bob's decision. Bob's decision is always accept. So this is how to say first condition. However, when Bob is honest, and also Bob is honest, and for different element, these two probability should be almost zero. Then this means that somehow different information. If different information obtained, in that case, there is no common, no different. This. So if if Bob receives same random variable z1 and z2, in that case, there is no different M and M prime and Z and Z prime satisfy this acceptance condition simultaneously. So this means that Alice cannot change message in the second stage, so reveal stage. So this is the second condition. So we need two conditions. So now we want to back the secure-list decoding. So we, in order to realize that kind of string bit commitment, we need these three conditions for the secure-list decoding. First condition is the following. So this is correctness. Somehow, the message should be contained Bob's list. So this is a very easy. This is a correctness condition in some sense. And second condition is related to concealing condition. So Bob cannot identify message M in the phase I, so first phase. And Alice cannot find another element among L messages. So of course, if Alice can find another message, Alice only knows that M is included in the list of candidates. So, but if Alice can find another element in the Bob's list, Alice can make cheating. But we need to forbid this cheating. So then we need this condition. This is corresponding to the binding condition. So we want to consider a secure list decoding by considering these three conditions. So this is a more rigorous formulation for the secure list decoding. So this is encoder and this is a decoder. Decoder has some set. Sorry, this is subset, not element. No, sorry, this is mistake. This is subset. And that subset, cardinality of that subset should be L. And there is this one. And we have a verifiable condition. This is somehow usual correctness or reliability condition. So there is this one has very small error probability of incorrect decoding. So this is small error, small incorrect decoding probability. So we need to consider that first condition. And the second one, we have a equivalent version of concealing condition. So somehow slightly different from the that kind of bit commitment, but why is Bob's message, Bob's receiving signal, Bob receive Y, so conditioned Y, there is a very large uncertainty. So this uncertainty should be larger than R. So we need this condition. And third condition is a binding condition for honest one. If Alice send a message by using M information by sending this code file, so in that case, there is no other element to include this one with very high probability. So this event is very small. But that condition assumes some honest behavior for Alice. Somehow, if Alice is not honest, in that case, Alice will not employ encoder. Only Alice send X somehow very cheating way. So Alice don't need to choose the code one. Only Alice send some X. So that X has some very cheating one because this kind of quantity has there is a two element such that this one is very large. But in that case, if we have a two element X such that this probability is very large, in that case, Alice can make cheating. So Alice can change some her message. So for example, there is a M1 and M2 has very large this probability. In that case, in the final stage, Alice can choose both of messages. So then we need to forbid such kind of cheating. So in order to forbid that kind of cheating, we need this condition. So then we have a capacity definition. So to define the capacity, we have some capacity region. Because, of course, we need that this condition for our code, this error probability must be zero, and also this is somehow cheating probability for Alice. So this probability should go to zero. So we need these two conditions, and we have three kind of rate. First rate is this one. This one is the size of message, and the second one size of error, so risk. So we have a two parameter, R1 and R2. And this one is related to concealing condition, equivocation. This one corresponds to equivocation. So equivocation value go to some rate, R3. So we consider three parameters, three rates. So this triple of rate is achievable. In this sense, so then we consider a set of this achievable rates, tuple of rates, a triplet of rates. So this one is the definition of our capacity region. This capacity region can be written as in that way. So we need to consider distribution of X and V. V is the sum of auxiliary system. And for each P, we can define this mutual information, condition mutual information. U is some auxiliary system. So this one is defined by this one. And of course, this X and cross P is defined by this distribution. And under this distribution, you can define this condition mutual information. So we have, there is several mutual information. Using this mutual information, you can define this region, red region. So this is our result. This result holds even when the output system is continuous. This is the advantage. Because previous Andreas Winter et al.'s paper, they assume that their all sets should be discrete. So then, but we don't need to assume this continuity. But in that situation, we need to assume X should be a finite. X is a finite set. But Y is maybe a continuous. This is very general set, including the Gaussian system. And now I want to explain how to make the bit string commitment protocol based on our secure list decoding. So this is not so trivial because, well, firstly, we have prepared a secure list decoding of Phi and Psi. Then later, we need to prepare a regular hash function from M to K. So in this case, K is a set of messages. K is a message set. So maybe this is K-bar. K-bar, K-bar. K-bar is a message set. We need to choose slightly smaller set than K. So, and then using this hash function, we have this triple. So using this triple, we can canonically construct protocol for bit string commitment. So firstly, we consider a commitment phase. So in that case, when the message is K, including the K bar, is to be sent by Alice, so she randomly choose the element of M subject to the uniform distribution on the F inverse K. So this is the first stage. So this is very common method for the wire dump channel model. Then Alice send phi M in this way. So this, maybe this is rather to the to Bob via noisy channel. This is a commitment phase. Of course, Bob needs to recover an L message. So from the receiving information in the commitment phase, Bob outputs L element from received message. This is subset of M as a list. So then Alice send M to via M to Bob via noiseless channel. The list is required to contain the message M. So if the transmitted message via noiseless channel is contained the Bob's decoding list, Bob can accept it. otherwise, and recover this message. So Bob send large M and Bob recover and Alice send M. Then Bob needs to apply M. Then Bob can recover original message K. So otherwise, Bob should reject it. In that situation, we need to prepare three security parameters for bitstring commitment based on the secure list decoding. So first one is binding condition, but this is exactly equal to the delta D parameter of the secure list decoding. And considering condition is somehow this one. So this is somehow this one. Then we have this one provided. And we have a three sides. This is the size of the message, and this is size of the this one. This is size of list. And third one is a true message. So K is a true message, and M1 is a message on the of the K is a message of bitstring commitment. And this one is, first one is corresponding to the message of the secure list decoding. And the second one corresponds to the list on the secure list decoding. So then we can define capacity region in the same way. So then we have a same achievable rate. So then, and also this result holds even in the continuous case. But we want to consider extension to the continuous input system. This is a more complicated one. So Nascimento et al. Shows the capacity is infinite when infinite many constrained points are allowed in the Gaussian channel. Of course, this is somehow trivial because the original address result with the et al.'s result already showed that the capacity region, if we increase the input number of input, then that kind of capacity goes to infinity. So then somehow this is somehow trivial. However, in the realistic situation, it is very difficult to implement infinitely many constraint points for honest arrays. So this is somehow a problem. So then we want to consider a following situation. So honest arrays can access only finite number of constraint points. However, this honest arrays access infinitely many constraint points. For example, this is 8PSK modulation. In that case, honest arrays only access on the this 8 point. But dishonest arrays can access any point on the this space, this space, compressed plane. So now we want to make a good formulation for that situation. X is a set of the access input system for honest arrays. However, X tilde is maybe this is a continuous set, accessible input system for dishonest arrays. So in that case, encoder is should be defined on the this small system and discrete set on. And however, we need to change binding condition, condition D. In that case, arrays can choose X tilde. X tilde is element of the script X. So we need to allow that kind of X tilde. So in that case, we need to consider a second largest value of this probability for each X tilde, and we consider that maximum value. So this value should be smaller than some constant. This is security parameter. So under that extension, we have a same result, because in that case, still, X for honest arrays is discrete. Then we have a complete the same capacity formula. So then this result holds even in the continuous output Y. So. This is a capacity reason for the secure list decoding. Then we can same way we define capacity reason for the bit string commitment based on the secure list decoding. We can extend that result to the case of bit string commitment. Then we have the same capacity reason formula. So this is the conclusion. We have proposed a new concept of secure list decoding, which has additional requirements for the conventional list decoding. And this schema has three requirements, verifiable condition, and equivalence version of constraining condition, and binding condition. We have applied this result to bit commitment. And also, we have extended our result to the case with continuous input-output case. This is a reference. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much for your talk, Masahiro Hayashi. I don't see any questions on the Slack channel. So I would request people to, I mean, if they have questions, they could directly unmute themselves and go ahead with them. Any questions? Alright, so I don't see anybody coming forth for questions, and I don't see anything in the chat either, nor do I see any questions posted on Slack. So I would like to thank Masahiro Hayashi for his talk, and we will now break for lunch, and we will resume again at 1400 hours Taipei time. Thank you very much.